Hey, how you doing? Andy with you for another song lesson. Today we're taking a look at Pink, Raise Your Glass. Pretty straight ahead song, nothing too tricky to get you caught out, so you'll be glad to know all of that. I have a chart for you to follow through with this one, a tab to check out, so click the link below and you'll be able to follow through with that and then have that handy for after you've gone through this lesson, completely free to get. So, you've grabbed that, let's have a look at what we've got going on. There's basically two sections in this. There is the verse section and the chorus section. I'm going to show you how to play it on acoustic, and it's going to be completely adaptable to play on electric as well if you want to play it in a band situation, but I'm figuring most people are wanting to learn this for their own, you know, solo purposes. So here's what we've got. If you follow through the tab there, we start up on the 9th and 10th fret on the D and the A string. So first finger on the D string, 9th fret, second finger on the A string, 2nd fret. And I'll play through this starting from this little section, and then I'll break it all down. So there is our starting point there. We're up on the 9 and the 10, and we're going to hit that two times. Cool. Then we're going to move down from there, down to the 4th and the 5th fret. Cool. And then down another two frets to 2 and 3. So it's a moving shape that we've got there. So putting that all together so far, up on the 9 and the 10, 5 and 4, and then 2 and 3, and then again on the 2 and 3. So we've got, and then an interesting little chukka rhythm we've got. So that's going to be single strum, and then we're going to mute those strings and get down up. That's the chukka. And then the strum again, downstroke. So that is. How do you get that? Simply release your fingers. You're not taking your fingers all the way off the fret, but we're just releasing the tension on the string. So we get that sound. So putting that together. Great. From there, similar idea for the second half. We're now going to start again on the 2 and 3 for the second half. And we're going to move up to the 5th fret, but this time, instead of keeping that same shape, we're going to extend our 3rd finger up to the 7th fret, and we're going to get a slightly wider shape. So 5 and 7, same strings, and then back down to the 5 and 4 that we did before. And then we're going to get the same idea as before. Strum, chukka, strum. So, putting that all together. Now the count may catch you out to start with. Just break it down slowly. I'll do it one time slow before we move on to the next section. Sweet, there is our verse section. From there, we're going to be getting a few chords. We're going to get G. We're going to get C. If you're a complete beginner and you're not familiar with any of these chords, check out the chord lessons that I have for you with the link here. My other channel helps you out with all those things. For this, I just want to get straight into things. So if you need those chords, you can check them out. E minor, and then from there, we've got D. Cool, so nice, good common chords. G, C, E minor, D. Okay, I'll play through the chorus section. 1, 2, 3. What have we got there? I'll slow it down first, see if you can pick it up, and then I'll give you some details.